So what I'm wanting to do now is to use some fluorescence. Just like the pop of color. Skinny Love has come on like so many times. Like, what the crap? I think this is Skinny Love. Sounds like it. I can't tell. It is Skinny Love. I was like, I can't tell if I hope that I'm right. Just to say, ooh, I'm right, or if I hope that I'm wrong so I don't have to hear it again. I like this song, but this is literally, I feel like, the third time I've heard it today. It's come on a lot on this channel. Whatever. I wonder how common it is for people in the creative industry, like fine artists, that I wonder how common it is for there to be an overlap. Like, an artist is also musically inclined, or fine artist is you know, also a strong writer, or I often wonder that, because a lot of times people are mostly known for, you know, one thing, but it doesn't necessarily mean that they're not strong in other areas. I'm just very curious if a creative individual is creative across the board. And obviously, I know everybody's different, but I mean, how common is it? Because I find that I have difficulty differentiating between different areas of creative strength, like, because they all kind of come from the same place. So it's difficult for me to imagine that there's somebody who's just a strong fine artist and they have like zero like design skills. I honestly don't understand that. Like, I feel like so many of the principles are the same. I don't understand how they don't apply. Well, I guess though musical ability would be different, but even with that, I mean, you've got balance, you've got repetition, you've got a focal point, you've got, it's like the things that make a strong composition are, yeah, whatever. Comment in the comment section. It's a joke. Okay, so you would think that you don't have to actually contemplate the color too carefully, but I'm really struggling right now to find the right color. I have a huge problem, personally, with things being in rainbow order or for colors appearing together that are like two together, not a problem. Three close together, like red, orange, and yellow, that drives me absolutely nuts. For me, it's like lyrics in a song that rhyme so obviously. It's like, can you try just a little bit? I mean, it's one thing to be catchy, but then we'll just say it's catchy. We won't say it's a good song. Now this is something I've been like, so I'm creating this piece, and clearly one of the cool things about it is that it's symmetrical. I can almost hardly imagine, I cannot imagine a composition where each side is a different color. That's not true. I could probably make that work, but the symmetry, not only in the form, but also in the colors, to me is one of the most powerful things about, I've done a couple of these. It kind of feels like a totem. It's like sometimes you try to figure out what makes something strong or powerful composition or work or whatever it is. And obviously it's a combination of things, but sometimes it feels like if you were to tweak one thing or even a percentage of one thing, you know, you'd have, it's like a choose your own adventure. You know, every art piece is its own thing, its own sort of being. And if you start to go in a different direction, the end result will be completely different. And for me, that's the stuff I labor over. And since I've had children, I can use that word. I mean, I really struggle to make that decision, because however you whatever choice you make will affect the outcome. And yes, I hear the symbolism in that. That's why it makes it difficult to make decisions, because you know, on the one hand it is so powerful. On the other hand, you got to do something or risk doing nothing at all, you know? I guess it's like the parable of the sower. Like, yeah, it's risky to invest your life because you could lose everything, or to risk a day, you know, like, how will you spend this day? Are you going to take a gamble? Or are you going to be too scared to lose that you decide to just, that preserving your life is enough, that just getting to the next day is enough without anything to show for it? So, like, what does God say is a life well invested? And for me personally, that's my measure. Like, somebody else could say, well, a life well lived is XYZ. But for me, what I really want is a life well lived that my Creator could say, well done. The lyrics. I surrender who I've been for who you are. Nothing makes me stronger than your fragile heart. I found what I've been living for. I love the piano and the, I got a text, I want to swipe it, yay! Thinking. When I wear these, when I use these, because they're water soluble. I don't know why, but the pencils, and this is a light color anyway, so the pencil shows through and that drives me nuts. So gotta get rid of the pencil. I'm really liking the sporadic use of fluorescence. I like that song.
Happy.
13 minutes. I don't care if this is boring for somebody else. I don't know why I'm even doing it, other than to kind of have an insight. I do want to have an insight. What's it like? See it through fresh eyes. See myself through fresh eyes. See the creative process, hear myself as though, you know, as though I'm more of an observer. Maybe there's something I can learn. Oh, time's up.